Hello students, I am Asha Shahu and you are watching channel Exam Track. Today we are going to start one more new chapter, How Do Organisms Reproduce? Okay, this is very important chapter and more interesting chapter also. Okay, so one important thing, I want to tell you, okay, you have seen so many people surrounding you, okay. So have you think all are not exactly similar, okay? So why they are not similar? We can see variation in a different form, in a various parameters, like in the form of height. They are not of the same height, they are not having the same color, okay? So there are number of variations, okay? All peoples are not exactly similar. And if you see the parents of that people, okay, they are also not exactly similar, okay? So it means offsprings are not exactly carbon copy, or they are not exactly similar to their parents, okay? Why offsprings are not exactly carbon copy to their parents? These all things we'll study in this chapter, okay? So let us start. How do organism reproduce? Okay, basically there are two type of organisms as we know, okay, unicellular and multicellular. It means both type of organism can reproduce, okay? So but what are the different ways of reproduction, how they reproduce? Okay, they are the two type of organisms, so they will reproduce by a different ways, okay? Both ways are not similar, okay? So first of all, define reproduction. What is reproduction? It is a biological process in which living organisms give birth to young one of their own kind. Okay, it is a process of generation, production of new organism from their parents. Okay, and maybe that offsprings may be exactly similar, or maybe some dissimilarities, or maybe some variation will arise. Okay, so that is whole reproduction. Okay. For one important thing, why reproduction is important, okay, significance of reproduction. So it ensures continuity of life of different species on earth. Through reproduction we can maintain a race of species, we can maintain a different species on this earth, okay? If reproduction will stop, can you imagine, one by one species will vanish from this earth, okay? So to maintain the balance, or to maintain the different species, okay, life of different species, reproduction is very important event, okay? Now students, all of you see here, these are the two ways, okay, basically two ways of reproduction, okay, asexual and sexual, okay? So first of all, we should know difference between asexual and sexual reproduction, okay? So asexual, first of all, we'll see first point. Asexual reproduction, it involves single parent, okay? Asexual, it means such type of process, such type of reproduction process involve single parent. It means uniparent is required for such type of reproduction, okay? And but in case of sexual reproduction, it involves two parents, that is male and female parent, okay? It requires two parent in which sexual reproduction. Second point is what, it involves less variation. Through asexual reproduction, there is a very less chances to see variation, to develop variation, very less chances, okay, to develop variation. But in case of sexual reproduction, there is a variation, okay, there is more variation we can see. For example, offsprings. So offsprings are not exactly similar to their parent, okay, so due to sexual reproduction, because in that there is a exchange of gamete, okay, crossing over. Due to crossing over, we'll discuss, okay, in the next chapter, okay, heredity and evolution, okay. And third point is, it is a short duration process, okay. In this, less time is required for this asexual process, okay. While in sexual process, it required a long time, okay, to propagate, okay, to produce new organism. Fourth difference is what species cannot adapt according to environmental change. Okay, in such type of organisms or species, they cannot adjust themselves and according to changing environment. Okay, so this is one demerit of asexual reproduction. So, while we in the case of sexual reproduction, in this species can adapt, okay, according to environmental changes. Okay, that is in evolution we have to study Darwin's law of natural selection. Okay, so according to environment we have to change ourselves so that we can survive, otherwise we will wash out. Okay, fifth difference is it does not lead to evolution. Of course, if there is a less chances of variation, then how evolution will arise? There is no chances of evolution, because evolution, in those cases evolution will arise, there is a chances of variation, because variation is the base of evolution. Okay, but in the case of sexual reproduction it leads to evolution. Why? Because there is a variation. We can see more variation in sexual reproduction, so it leads to evolution. It means origin of new species. Okay, from evolution. From evolution, we can see. Okay, example for asexual reproduction: Hydra and amoeba. Okay, these are the example of asexual reproduction. And while sexual reproduction, human. Okay, best example. And flowering plants. Flowering plant. Plant case also sexual reproduction, but which type plant? In flowering plants sexual reproduction occur. Okay, so now it's very clear, all of you can see. Okay, now students, here reproduction, there are two ways of reproduction, asexual and sexual reproduction. These are two types, okay, of reproduction. We know asexual reproduction, which single parents are involved, uniparent. Okay, so there are various ways of asexual reproduction. Okay, first is by binary fission. Okay, which organism? Okay, in amoeba, paramecium, leishmania. These are unicellular organisms. This one, protozoan, leishmania. Okay, next one, by multiple fission. Okay, where it occurs? Okay, it occurs in plasmodium and cnidomonas. Multiple fission. Okay, more than two organism. Okay, budding in which organism? Hydra and yeast. Okay, Hydra is a cylindrate. Okay, yeast is a what? It is a fungi. Okay, ascomycetes. Next one, fragmentation. Okay, fragmentation, through fragmentation, where it occur? In a spirogyra. Spirogyra is what? Is a filamentous algae. Okay, now next one, regeneration. Through regeneration, who can reproduce? Hydra and Planaria. Okay, next one, spore formation. Spore formation occur in fungus, of course we know. So fungi usually they reproduce through spore formation. Example, rhizopus and mucor. Okay, and next one, vegetative propagation. Through vegetative propagation, it means except flower, different other parts of plant. Okay, like root, a stem and leaves, but except flower. Why? Because flower is a reproductive organ of plant. Okay, so these are by root. Who can reproduce? Sweet potato. Sweet potato is a example of root. It is a modified root. Okay, the markdown students. Okay, potato tuber. Potato is a modified stem. By stem, which reproduce? A potato tuber. And by leaves, bryophyllum. Bryophyllum, you can see there is a like bird like on the leaf. So many birds arise, okay, that will arise a new bryophyllum. So by leaves, these are the ways of vegetative reproduction. Okay, now students, see here, this is binary fission in amoeba. This diagram showing, okay, here is a single amoeba. Okay, here inside the nucleus is there, and there is a cytoplasm. Okay, it is a unicellular organism, single cell. Okay, whenever it is going to start, okay, division, so first of all nucleus will grow here. Okay, nucleus will grow and they will form like this structure. This process is known as what? Karyokinesis. Okay, after the growing of nucleus, there is a division of nucleus occur. So first of all nucleus will grow and it divide. Okay, this is known as karyokinesis. It means karyon means nucleus. okay, and kinesis means breakdown. Okay, so it results karyokinesis, and after that division there will be division of cell cytoplasm. You can see here cell cytoplasm is here. Okay, so this is known as cytokinesis. Okay, so first of all karyokinesis and cytokinesis. So there is two event occur in a binary fission in amoeba, karyokinesis and then cytokinesis. Okay, and after that there is a two independent daughter amoeba will form. You can see in the diagram it is given daughter amoeba, there is two. Okay, after cytokinesis, after division of cell cytoplasm. So this is a binary fission in amoeba. Clear? Now multiple fission in plasmodium. Okay, this is a plasmodium. Okay, it is a malarial parasite, we know. Okay, it is present in our RBC, our red blood cells. Okay, so here what happened, your nucleus multiply repeatedly a number of time. Okay, and after the multiplication it finally burst. Okay, RBC cells burst and they release of parasites. Okay, the number of plasmodium parasites, these are released. So this is an example of multiple fission in plasmodium. Now students, all of you see here, this is budding in Hydra. Okay, this diagram showing budding in Hydra. Okay, Hydra is what? It is a cylindrate. Okay, it is a multicellular organism. Okay, and here we can see there is a, it is a parent body. Okay, and there is a small outgrowth is here. Okay, this is known as bud. Okay, small outgrowth here. There is origin of small outgrowth. Okay, after some time they will grow. Okay, this bud will grow and finally they will form like daughter Hydra. Second, third stage you can see here. Okay, first stage. Okay, this one, then this one, then this one. Okay, so after some time there will be daughter Hydra will form here. Okay, it is the outgrowth. Okay, and after some time there will be detachment. This Hydra will separate. Okay, after splitting. Okay, and it will form two complete Hydra. One is a parent body and this one new Hydra. Okay, this one new Hydra and this is the old parent body. Okay, so now it both are interdependent. Okay, independent. Okay, they are not dependent to each other. Okay, so this is a way of budding in Hydra. Okay, I think it's very clear. Okay, there is no doubt. Okay, now next one, a fragmentation in a spirogyra. Okay, spirogyra, we know it is a filamentous algae. Okay, it is a green algae. Okay, it is commonly present in pond, river. Okay, we can see. Okay, easily. So fragmentation, what is fragment? First of all we should know. Okay, fragment, in this body is divided into two or more than many parts. Okay, more than two parts. So each part is known as fragment, and each fragment give rise to a new spirogyra. Okay, so that's why it is known as fragmentation. Spirogyra splits, they produce through fragmentation. So you can see it is a spirogyra diagram, and here is splitting from the middle, and after middle there is a formation of two spirogyra. These are but they are not dependent to each other. Okay, they are independent, okay, from each other. Okay, so this is a fragmentation in a spirogyra. Now students, a spore formation, okay, in rhizopus. Okay, this is a way of sexual reproduction in fungus. Okay, spores, if you see the diagram, then such type of diagram will be there. Okay, so this is the actually fungus mycelium. Okay, hyphae diagram. This one rhizoidal hyphae, this one actually hyphae. Okay, and these are the sporangiophore. It is a rhizopus fungi, so it will be rhizophore. Okay, and it is here, it is a columella structure, and here it is a bag like structure. Spores are covered inside the bag, it is known as a sporangium bag. Okay, and after some time there will be dispersal of this spores. Okay, dehiscing sporangium, you can see the next diagram, dehiscing sporangium, after bursting it will release the spores. Okay, this is a single spore. So in such way there is a reproduction, asexual reproduction occur in rhizopus. Okay, is a type of fungi. You can see it is in our bread also. If you keep bread, okay, for 2 or 3 days, okay, so you can see in green coloration is there, okay, and that is what it is, nothing, it is the rhizopus bread mold, okay. Now students, here regeneration in planaria, okay. This is a way, this is a process through which a organism can repair its lost part, okay. It's they can grow their lost part, they can repair their damaged part, okay. But it is not an assurance for development of a whole organism, okay. Because if we see in planaria, this process, okay, each part they can give a new planaria, but this is not valid for all type of multicellular organism, okay. So we can see each here there is a regeneration. They can regenerate, they can repair their damaged part, okay. But it is not a sexual reproduction, okay. Why? Because it is not valid for multicellular organism. Multicellular organism can't form new organism through this technique, through this regeneration process. Okay? And one important thing is that there is a difference between regeneration and fragmentation. Okay, we have to remember this. Fragmentation, what happened in that process, each fragment give rise to a new spirogyra. Okay, each fragment. But here it is valid in planaria, but not for all multicellular organisms. Okay. Little students, start here. Artificial propagation of plants. Okay, how plant propagation occurs by artificial means, okay, by artificial way. Okay, so there are three different ways, okay, cutting, layering and grafting. Okay, so what is cutting? Okay, what are the example of cuttings? Okay, through this process which type of plant we can grow? Okay, cutting, in this process there is the small cut of like branches, stem, okay, roots, okay, and through that we develop a new plant. Okay, so example banana, we see, okay, in our like garden, banana, rose, grape, sugar cane, okay, these are grow through cutting process, okay. And then second is layering. In this process, what small branches of any plant, okay, it is placed inside the soil, okay, and after some time we can see there is a root formation in that branch, okay, and it will develop a new plant, okay. So this is a process, layering. Which type of plantation? Jasmine plant and grapevine, okay, they propagate through layering process, okay. And third type of artificial means of propagation is grafting, okay. Grafting, it is actually the composition, it is a union, it is a process of joining, it is a technique of joining of the two plant, okay. How? Okay, in this there is a shoot system is, okay, grafted over and the stump of another plant, okay, and finally they will form a new plant, okay, and that having the both quality from the previous stem and the next one, that is the shoot system. It means the previous one or where it has to be kept, okay, that is known as stalk, okay, and the remaining other is known as scion, okay. Stalk and scion combined to form a new composite plant, okay. So which type of plantation occur through this process? Apple, mango, lemon and orange, through this process they can occur, okay. We have seen in the diagram also, okay. Next one, advantage of vegetative propagation. This is very important, okay, for examination point of view, board exams point of view. Advantage of vegetative propagation, okay, what are the advantages, okay. Vegetative propagation, we know that is the propagation of plant, okay, through stem, root and leaves, except flower, because flower is a reproductive, sexual reproduction occur through flower, okay, that not involved in a vegetative reproduction, okay. So, what are the advantages? First is multiplication of seedless plant like banana, sugarcane, rose. Okay, we know we grow plant through seeds. Okay, but what about those plant that having no any seeds? So how we can grow? So this is the way. Okay, one of the way of multiplication of seedless plant. Okay, like banana. Otherwise, seed is there. If seed is there also, but that is not capable to produce a new plant. That is not viable. Okay, so such type of plant also can propagate through this. Okay, vegetative propagation we can develop a new plant through this process. Okay, second one, development of genetically similar varieties through this process. Whatever the plant will develop, will generate, will propagate, they are genetically will be similar. Okay, third is it is a rapid method of multiplication. Okay, how we can say it is a rapid way of multiplication? Because the plant, those one growing through this technique, they will develop early, they produce early fruits and flowers rather than the those plants growing from the seeds. Okay, so these are the advantages of what? Vegetative propagation. Okay, so we have completed. Okay, asexual reproduction, a type of reproduction. There are basically two type of reproduction, asexual and sexual. So asexual part we have almost finished. Okay, so in next video we'll start sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Okay, so till then, keep watching and please like and subscribe this channel. Okay, then thank you, goodbye, take care.